This world is compared to a tree in the Rig Veda. 1164.20. In the Rig Veda, this world is compared to a tree. This is the tree of the cosmos. This is the tree of the universe. This is the tree of the world. And this tree has branches, as you can see. And perched on all these branches of the tree are birds. I wouldn't count animal souls, but every human soul, in addition to animal souls too, but I wouldn't count animal souls. And the last I heard is that this earth has 7 billion human beings or thereabout. 7 billion souls, comparable to being birds, are perched on the branches of this tree. And that includes you and me as we listen to this pravachan, this lecture being given. And at the top of the tree, there's a different, another bird that is characteristically different from all these other birds. These 7 billion birds sitting on these trees, on these branches, look at me. Their vision is downwards. They watch down. And in watching down, they look for the berries, the fruits of this tree. And if they pick a sweet fruit, they smile. And if they pick and taste a bitter fruit, they cry. Aur yehi hasna aur rona, aapka anubhav hai, aur mera bhi anubhav hai. This is the experience of all these bird souls. They do karmas. You and I perform karmas. And if we perform a righteous, virtuous karma, the result is sweet. And when we taste the fruit of our sweet karmas, we smile and we laugh. And if perchance we engage in bad karma, when the fruit comes, the fruit is very bitter to taste. And we cry. And we laugh and we cry and we laugh and we cry and we smile and we carry a stare blank, and there are tears here or they are not tears. Our sara jeevan yahi hasna rona chalta rehta hai. And this is all we do all the time. And there's the bird up there, this bird up here. He watches me and you. You and I, as birds, we keep eating all the time. Mane karma hum kar rahe hain. We keep engaging in actions all the time. Depending on what we do, that will be the consequence. But this bird does nothing. This bird doesn't eat. This one up here. And this bird watches me and you and asks, when will my son Satish raise the level of his glance and watch me and recognize me? And in recognizing me, when will he flap his two wings? In this case, the wing of thought and the wing of understanding, the wing of mind and the wing of intellect. When will he flap his two wings and jump from this branch to this branch, that I can give him the sweet fruit that we call mukti and emancipation? One more thing. This bird has feathers, and these birds also have feathers, but these feathers are dark feathers. I wouldn't want to say black, dark feathers, because you and I are sunk in ignorance. And the word ignorance is a rough term, but it means a loss of knowledge here. You and I are sunk in a loss of knowledge. And this bird doesn't have black feathers. This bird has golden feathers, because knowledge and knowledge alone characterizes its being and existence. And so his feathers are golden and our feathers are dark. Dva suparna sayuja sakhaya. Dva tu suparna, birds with beautiful wings and feathers. Suparna, beautiful wings. Dva suparna, when you learn some Sanskrit, you are lost in these chantings, especially when you can go to the etymology of the word and you can understand meanings immediately. Dva tu suparna, birds with beautiful wings. Dva suparna sayuja sakhaya. And the two birds you're talking about is this one and me. even though there are 7 billion, but we are individualizing our existence right now. This bird and me, and I'm right here. Twa suparna sayuja, close. Sakaya, friends. These two birds are close friends, sweet friends. And you know what? Samanam vriksham ekahi vrikshapar, on one tree, on this common tree. Parishasva jate, they are both seated. Me and he and I. He and I are seated on the one tree. But the difference is, tayoranyaha pippalam swaduati. Of these two, me and he, I am eating fruits. Tayoranyaha pippalam swaduati. Anashnan bina khaye hue, without eating, anashnan anyaha abhicha kashiti, he watches on in silence. Ah, tasye dahuhu pippalam swadu agre. And they say, at the top, there is this higher bird, golden colored, and he has a sweet banana fruit, ripened. Sweet. And he's hoping and praying. God is hoping and praying. Ki ek na ek din Satish ki nazar, Satish ki drishti, khane peene mauj urane ke star se upar aa jayegi. That Satish's vision will rise above the level of just eating, drinking and making merry. He will rise above those animal instincts. And he will see me with the fruit. And he will soon flap his two wings of mind and intellect and come all the way up here. Tasye dahu pippalam swadu agre. But the sad thing is, and the stark reality is, tanno nashat yah pitaram daveda. Jo pita ko na jane, wo is phal ko nahi chakhega. He who does not know the father, this father here, he, meaning you and he and she and me and they and us and all of us, if we don't know the Father, we cannot taste that fruit. Hamara adhikar nahi hai. It would not be our privilege. Ab aapke saamne ek chunauti hai. Not sirf aapke saamne, mere saamne. Hum sabke saamne ek chunauti hai. You and I have a challenge. Wo din kab aa jayega? When is that day gonna come? When you and I will at least begin the process of getting to know the Father, that ultimately we can fly all the way up there and we can taste that fruit. Rigved. And then it continues, he says, but one day it happens. We are not destined only to be looking down. And we are not destined only to eat sweet and bad fruits all the time. We are not destined only to cry and laugh all the time. That's too animalistic. We need some divinity in our lives. And so one day it happens that one of these people in New Zealand coming to the Vedic cultural, the Vedic center and the Arya Samaj, or even that Sanatan Dharma Mandir, or even in a mosque, or even in a church, or even in a synagogue, but an Atma, suddenly was inspired to raise its vision. That's where your destiny and my destiny lies. Raise its vision. And this is what the Veda says. Yada pashya pashyate rukma varanam. When the seeing one, now Satish begins to see. When the seeing one raises its vision and glance and perceives the golden colored bird. When Satish, and I don't mean myself only, all you Satishes here, when Satish one day raises his glance and perceives the golden colored bird, look what happens. Let me chant it, I love to chant it. Yada pashya pashyate rukmavaranam kartaram isham purusham brahmayonim, and sees that in having golden color, he's the karta, he made this cosmic spectacle possible. He designed it and he filled it with resources for me, this bird here, to enjoy and one day to climb and to flap and to fly to higher levels of existence. Karataramisham purusham brahmayonim, and sees this bird as the Brahma, as the Isham, the owner of the tree. I don't own the tree. I don't own the car, I don't own the house, I don't own the husband, I don't own the wife, I don't own the children, I don't own the money in the bank, I don't own the land somewhere in the interior. Yes, it's been lent to me, and I'm required to take good care of it, and I'm required to use it, and I'm required to put it at my to my advantage that I can climb. These are things, wife, husband, money, land, children, friends. These are things on the rung of the ladder of life that I can climb and climb and climb and reach the top. And one day have the privilege of tasting the fruit. But he's the Ish, the owner. Are Malik to what he is? He is Kartaram Isham Purusham Brahmayonim. He is creator, owner, and the source of knowledge. Then look what happens. Tada vidwan tabuv. Woh knowing one banta hai. Ab dwara ignorance nahi rahta uski man mein. Then becoming a scholar. Not in terms of a literal scholar, but a knowing one, then becoming knowledgeable. He gives up all good and bad karma. Tada vidvan punya pape vidhuya. And look what happens. Niranjanaha. He becomes spotless. He becomes free from the taint of ignorance generated vicious karma. He becomes free from the taints of all of that. And you know what happens? Paramam samyam upaiti. And then he flaps his wings and he comes up here and he approaches the supreme equipoise, God himself, who embodies supreme happiness. All of you, whether you belong to a Sanatani Mandir or an Arya Samaji Mandir, it makes no difference to me. We are all Aryas. Even a white man is an Arya. Even a black man is an Arya. Even a Japanese is an Arya. Because Arya doesn't refer to race. It doesn't connote race. It connotes character. It connotes personality. It connotes a noble inclination. And we are all Aryas. And this is the destiny that we must now cherish for ourselves. When we can become free from taints caused by actions generated by ignorance. And we can one day flap our wings and reach the very top. The tragedy of life is that you and I, when we were supposed to use this body as a ladder to climb, when we were supposed to use this wing of mind and this wing of intellect to be wings that we can flap to rise all the way up here, we made this body into a pinjara, into a cage. And then we want to get out from the cage. I don't know if you all have it here, but when I was a boy growing up in my village in Guyana, British Guyana, my neighbor used to have 3 and 4 bird cages. And I would go there and I would watch these birds. They fly to this end of the cage and there is a barricade, these wires. And he can't get out to freedom. And then he flies this way and he can't get out. And he flies this way and he can't get out. And he flies this way and he can't get out. And he looks up and he can't get out. And that's what's happening to me and to you. Akaya ek pinjara hai panchi se lani ka kaya ek pinjara hai panchi se lani ka zindagi aur kuch bhi nahi
keys. Turn to the person sitting next to you and sing to him the tragedy that is occurring with you and me and all of us.
Kaya ek pinjara hai panchi se lani ka.
Very nice.
Zindagi aur kuch bhi nahi, bolo bolbola hai ye paani ka. Aaya ek pinjra.
Arre hum sab bolbol, hamara jeevan bolbola jaisa hoga. It can burst at any time. We can die at any time without achieving our objective of raising the level of our plants. Sing it one more time. That's all that life has become for me and for you, and we pray we feel like prisoners in this cage that we call the body. Raise your voices.
Sana hai swasan ki ra